In this topic, we shall discuss about the images formed by the convex mirror. Like that in concave mirror, here image also formed by the convex mirror. But there are two possible cases. One, when object is placed at infinity. And another is when object is placed in front of convex mirror anywhere at a distance equal to its center of curvature or at a distance of less than center of curvature equal to focus or less than focus greater than center of curvature. No matter, in all cases similar type of the images are formed. So there are two particular cases. One, when object is placed at infinity in front of convex mirror. When object is placed at infinity, we know that the light rays become parallel to each other, and these parallel incident rays, they come from the object. And when fall on convex mirror, we know that convex mirror is a divergent mirror, so it diverges the light rays in different directions. When these light rays fall on eye, then these appear coming from a point that is focus. Light rays do not actually come from the focus, but they appear coming from the focus. So image is formed at focus. Light rays appear coming from the focus, so image is virtual. So what is the position, size and nature of image formed by the convex mirror? When object is placed at infinity, then image form is what type? Number one, position at focus. Image focus pe banegi. Light rays appear diverging, actually not diverging from this point. Actually, actual pathway is this. Only light ray, say this incident ray come, fall on the mirror and reflected back. But it appear coming from this, so all the light rays like that appear coming from focus. So image appear at focus means it is formed at focus. Size diminished. Smaller than object. Light rays are not actually coming from this point, so it is virtual. And those images which are virtual, they are erect, virtual and erect. This is the position, size and nature of the image formed. And second possibility is what? When object is placed anywhere in front of the convex mirror. Convex mirror ke samne kahin pe bhi rakha ho. No matter if it is say beyond center of curvature, means the distance equal to center of curvature, because actually its center of curvature is on back side. And if you place object in back side, then image cannot be formed. Image is formed always when object is placed in front. So when object is placed anywhere, kahin pe bhi. Say object is placed here in front of the, this is AB. What happens, one light ray, same rule as we done in concave mirror. Anywhere other than infinity, कहीं पे भी, so it is placed here. One of the light ray move parallel and it is reflected back. It appear coming from the focus. So it is the center of curvature. Another light ray, we have to use such a way that it fall perpendicular. In such a way that it fall perpendicular and it appear coming from focus. It appear coming from center of curvature. Another light ray which fall on it perpendicular, and those light rays which fall perpendicular will be reversed back, and these are the two reflected rays, one this and this. These appear coming from this point. That appear coming from this point and the image is formed here. So when object is placed at infinity, then image is formed at focus in case of convex mirror. And if object is placed anywhere, then we have to show two light rays, one move parallel and that parallel reflected back and appear coming from the focus, and another fall perpendicular that appear coming from the center of curvature. And these appear, both of these reflected light rays, that is, say, MN and RS, these light rays, these appear coming from this point. So image is formed here, and this is A dash B dash. In this manner, we can place object anywhere in front of convex mirror, then image will always be formed between pole and focus. Always that will be formed between pole and focus. Always it will be diminished. Always it will be virtual and erect. We can place object anywhere in front of convex mirror other than infinity, then image will be always formed between P and F, pole and focus. That will be always diminished. That will be always virtual and direct. This is the characteristic of the image formed by the convex mirror, that is virtual, erect, diminished. These are the characteristics. And position is between P and F. These are the two major cases. Now, the uses of convex mirror. The very important use of convex mirror is as a rear view mirror in motor vehicles. In all motor vehicles, the rear view mirror which we see, in which we see the image of the any other vehicle or object behind the vehicle, that is convex mirror. Why it is used? Because it has wide field view. Its field view is very wide and it always form erect image and also diminished. So we can see the large size vehicle or any other object which is behind properly, completely in this mirror. And another is, it is used at strategic point, that is like sharp turns. The big size convex mirror, they are used at the sharp turns, so that the image of the motor vehicle which is coming from other side, that can be seen on it. And also it is used, large size convex mirror also used on the shop counters to see the view or wide view of the counter. These are the major uses of convex mirror. And now the mirror formula. What is mirror formula? It is the relationship between the object distance, image distance, and focal length of the mirror. And it is equal to 1 upon focal length of mirror is equal to 1 upon image distance plus 1 upon object distance, where F is focal length of mirror, may be convex, may be concave. Focal length of mirror. V is image distance from pole of mirror. And U is object distance from pole of mirror. This is mirror formula. It should be learned because there are numericals on the basis of this formula. And in this formula, value of these variables are put, but according to sign convention, which we shall discuss in the next lecture. 1 upon F is equal to 1 upon V plus 1 upon U, where F is focal length of the mirror, V is image distance from the pole of mirror, and U is distance of object from the pole of mirror. Mirror formula is same for convex mirror as well as concave mirror. Only difference is of sign convention, which we shall discuss in next lecture. Now the magnification. Linear magnification or simply magnification. Produced by mirrors. By a mirror. What is actually magnification? Magnification is the ratio of height of image to the height of object. What is magnification? Magnification is the ratio of, it is the ratio of height of image to the height of object. जो इमेज बनता है उसकी हाइट और जो ऑब्जेक्ट है उसकी हाइट की रेशियो. इफ इमेज इज एनलार्ज्ड देन मैग्निफिकेशन इज ग्रेटर देन वन. इफ साइज ऑफ इमेज इज इक्वल टू द साइज ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट देन मैग्निफिकेशन इज वन. एंड इफ साइज ऑफ इमेज इज लेस देन द साइज ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट देन मैग्निफिकेशन इज लेस देन वन. Because magnification, it is denoted by m, small letter m. So magnification m is equal to height of image, or it can be denoted say I stands for image, say height of object. Say HO, O stands for object. So if image is enlarged, then value of M will be greater than 1. And if image and object, they are of same size, then value of magnification will be 1. And if size of the image is smaller than, means diminished, then value of magnification will be less than 1. Then this is the formula. But in 6 cases of image which we studied for concave mirror, also in convex mirror in 2 cases we see that as the distance of the object from the mirror become less, then size of the image keep on increasing. Since the height of image depend upon the image distance, so it can also be represented like that. Magnification is equal to height of image to the height of object is equal to minus V upon U, where V is image distance and U is object distance. This is the actual formula for magnification, where M is magnification, HI means height of image, HO means height of object, V image distance, U object distance. M is equal to HI upon HO is equal to minus V upon U. This is the magnification formula. That's all for this topic in this lecture, and please subscribe it, and in next lecture we shall discuss the sign convention, and then a topic, theoretical topic of the reflection will be over, and after that we shall do the numerical. Have a nice day.